Today, we're going to be taking a look at the top 10 MCP servers that are connecting AI agents with the platforms and services that matter most.
Now, in case you're out of the loop here, the model context protocol was created by Anthropic back in November of 2024, and it took a little while for people to figure out how to successfully implement this thing and for it to start picking up steam and going viral the way that it is now. But it's open source, and it's a standard for connecting AI assistants to systems where data lives. So this could be content repositories, business tools, and development environments. The first one that I want to take a look at here is the GitHub MCP server. It's an open source project that transforms how AI tools interact with your code. And they did a nice little podcast episode here explaining what it is and also how it works. They give a couple of examples. So let's quickly take a look at that video.
We just open sourced this on Friday, and it's been well received. It's all open source. It works with our API. And so to install it, we've made it very easy. If you have VS Code or VS Code Insiders, you can simply click one of these buttons. You do need a couple things before you get it up and running. One is that you need to generate what we call a PAT, which is a personal access token, so that we can grant the MCP server permissions to do actions on your repos and grab data from our API. There's also the easiest way to set it up, which is with Docker. You can grab the binaries because this is a Golang project and it compiles and run it directly on your machine, but doing it with Docker is the easiest way. So if you're on VS Code, VS Code Insiders, just click this. It will prompt you for your personal access token, which you can generate by clicking on this. If you're in another sort of MCP host, you can look at these JSONs and you can paste them in. So here's the Claude desktop one, and you'll see it's asking for your personal access token. You can just go ahead and put that here. And after that, you should be able to run it.
So yeah, it's pretty powerful giving an AI agent access to the entirety of GitHub. And he did mention there that it does call the API, so it's not going to be entirely free to use, but it's still pretty powerful and definitely way more powerful than just a normal LLM with search functionality. Like, for example, if you went to ChatGPT and said, head over to GitHub and just tell me what the top 10 GitHub repositories are, and then summarize some themes or some characteristics about those top 10 repos, it's probably not going to give you as good of a result as if you were just using the GitHub MCP server with your AI agent. Okay, the next MCP server that I want to take a look at here is the Slack MCP server. And we can see right away that it has a couple of tools in its tool belt. It specifically enables Claude to interact with Slack workspaces. And so it can list all of the channels in a specific workspace. It can post messages on your behalf, which is pretty interesting. It can also reply in threads. It can add reactions as well. So basically, you could have an AI agent that is just doing stuff in Slack sort of on its own using this MCP server. It can take a look at channel history and see recent messages from a specific channel. It can also get thread replies, see what people are posting in a thread. It can also get all of the users in a workspace and just give basic profile information, or it can zoom in on one specific profile and get information for that specific user. Now, this next MCP server is a little bit different from that one, because while you can give an AI agent access to Slack so that it can leave replies and comments and reactions, the PostgreSQL MCP server is a little bit more limited in what it can do, and that's probably for the best. So it provides read-only access to PostgreSQL databases, and the server enables LLMs to inspect database schemas and execute read-only queries. The server provides schema information for each table in the database. And so what that means is you're going to get JSON schema information for each table. It includes column names and data types. And basically, it automatically discovers all of this from the database metadata. Next up, we've got the FastAPI MCP server, which exposes your FastAPI endpoints as model context protocol tools with auth. So if we scroll down here, we can see the features that are built into this MCP server. It includes authentication using your existing FastAPI dependencies. It also is FastAPI native. It's not just another OpenAI to MCP converter. There's also minimal configuration required. So you just point the MCP server at your FastAPI app and it just works. It preserves schemas of your request models and response models. It also preserves documentation of all your endpoints, just as it is in Swagger. And it's flexible to deploy. You can mount your MCP server to the same app or deploy separately. After that, we have the Notion MCP server. This is, as usual, open sourced. It's available on GitHub. So basically, it allows you to plug in your favorite client and start building richer AI integrations with Notion in minutes. So let's open up this repository here, and you can see that the project implements an MCP server for the Notion API. It gives instructions on how to install and how to get this whole thing up and running. And we've actually got this nice little example of how to make use of this MCP server. So we'll just click on this here. We can see that the user is using Claude 3.7 Sonnet, and it's actually asking to research a trip in Tokyo, a 2-day itinerary, and then adding it to the travel plans page in Notion. So it's doing a little bit of research. And then once it's done, you can see it updates the Notion page with all of that information. After that, it's asking for something else. It's saying, can you list the first name of the first 10 users in the Notion workspace? And so it's able to use this integration, this MCP server to, and actually the Notion API as well, to list off the first 10 users in the workspace. Now, it's one thing to give an AI agent access to a Notion page. It's quite another to give an AI agent access to your system, to your computer. And so that's exactly what the Filesystem MCP server does. It's a Node.js server implementing model context protocol for file system operations. And it has a couple of features here. You can read, write files. You can create, list, or delete directories. You can move files or directories, search files, and get file metadata. And the server, it's important to note, the server will only allow operations within directories specified via arguments. So you have control over where you want the AI agent to go and where you want it to not go. The next MCP server that I want to talk about here allows an AI agent to use a browser and basically access the entire internet. So specifically, it says it'll allow LLMs to interact with web pages, take screenshots, and execute JavaScript in a cloud browser environment. There's a more detailed list of features here: browser automation, controlling and orchestrating cloud browsers, data extraction, extracting structured data from any web page, console monitoring, tracking and analyzing browser console logs, which is going to be great for developers, taking screenshots of entire pages, JavaScript, like I mentioned earlier, executing custom JS in the browser context, and then web interactions. So doing the stuff that we normally do, navigating, clicking, and filling forms like you would with a keyboard. Now, this one also comes with another MCP server, the Stagehand MCP, which gives even more power to an LLM. It can execute precise actions like clicking on a specific button or extracting a specific phrase. It also supports multiple models like GPT-4 and Claude 3.7 Sonnet. It's modular, so it'll easily integrate with new models with minimal changes. It also offers vision support, so it uses annotated screenshots for complex DOMs. And then also, of course, it's open source. This next one gives an AI agent access to your private thoughts through Obsidian, which probably doesn't seem like something that most people would want to do, but let's say you take a lot of notes in Obsidian, you have a lot of these notes floating around and you want to summarize them, or you want to find specific themes or ideas. Maybe you took a note a couple of years ago and you can't track it down and the Obsidian search functionality isn't helping you, or maybe you want to track your own thoughts evolution over time. You want to see how your thoughts have gotten better or gotten worse over time. I think this MCP server would be a great way of doing that. It has comprehensive search capabilities. It enables AI assistants to seamlessly manage knowledge bases through a clean and flexible tool interface for Obsidian. In a similar vein for personal development, growth, and productivity, you've got the Todoist MCP server, which gives Claude access to your Todoist tasks, and it can actually interact with those tasks using natural language. And so what that means in practice is that Claude, now through the Todoist MCP server, can create, update, complete, and delete tasks. It can find tasks using partial name matches. It can filter tasks by due date, priority, and also other attributes. And this MCP server supports descriptions, due dates, and priority levels, and it also gives clear feedback for better user experiences as well. And then finally, this one is kind of similar to the Browserbase MCP server. It's the Selenium MCP server, and it gives an AI agent access to the internet through a browser. So you can start browser sessions with your AI agent using this server with customizable options, navigate to URLs, find elements using various locator strategies, click, type, and interact with elements like a human would, perform mouse actions as well, including hovering, dragging, and dropping, handling keyboard inputs, taking screenshots, uploading files, and also this MCP server supports headless mode too. And then one final point here is that this supports both Chrome and Firefox.
All right, those were our top 10 MCP servers. I really hope you enjoyed the video, and I'd love to know from you how you're using MCP servers on a day-to-day basis, so do leave a comment down below. And also, if you haven't already, please do like this video and hit subscribe so that you don't miss any of our future videos. All right, thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.